A warm hello to everyone. My name's Sarah Cordwell from BERNINA International, and today I'm going to show you how to prepare your Q series machine for the studio frame. I have our latest baby here, the Q16 Plus, but the steps I'm going to do are valid also for the Q16 and the Q20. Since this is the preparation for the studio frame, this does not apply to the Q24, as our big girl cannot be used on the studio frame. The machine is not very stable without the top carriers, so it is best to lay it on its side on a smooth surface, for which I'm going to use one of my quilt samples. Slide the machine to the edge of the table for easier access later. We have two top carriers, one towards the front and one towards the back. They look pretty much the same, but it is important that you use the one with the bigger opening in the middle as the front carrier. First, we are going to prepare the front top carrier and start with the damping carrier and these two long screws with two washers each. The damping carrier has to be mounted to the bottom. Now we need this threaded bolt with spring washer, which I'm going to screw tightly into one of the smaller drill holes from the top. Now, watch me carefully because getting the sequence right is important. Take this long screw and place the washer, the O-ring, and the circular sleeve on top. Please watch that the chamfer points towards the screw head. Don't let go of this construction. It needs to be inserted into the bigger drill hole in the middle of the damping carrier we have mounted before. Almost done. Turn the top carrier again and place the blue dampening mat onto the screw so the cutout encloses the threaded bolt. Here is a better view from the top. Now place the washer and the spacer on top. And screw it into the front slotted nut of the machine. Don't tighten it up, we still need to move the top carrier into its correct position. It's important to move the top carriers to the designated spots because of two reasons. First, because we need to optimize the quilt space when moving the machine on the frame. And secondly, to balance the machine for a smooth quilting feel. BERNINA calculated the optimal position for you and marked it with a sticker on the Q16 and the Q16 Plus. Move the front top carrier now, so the edge of the damping mat touches the tip of the printed arrow. For the correct position of the Q20 on a studio frame, please refer to your dealer. Don't forget to tighten the screw now. Now to the rear top carrier. Here, we simply attach this aluminium plate with the two smaller screws to the top of the top carrier. Insert the bigger screw with its washer from underneath into the middle opening. And screw everything into the rear slotted nut. Again, do not tighten as we need to position the top carrier first. One thing to watch. You can see that one of the V-wheel units is attached to a slotted hole. Please watch that both top carriers are mounted in a way that the slotted holes are on the same side of the machine. like we did for the front top carrier, move now the rear top carrier so the edge of the aluminium plate touches the tip of the printed arrow. Don't forget to tighten the screw now. The machine is now ready to be placed onto the carriage of the frame. The machine is small, but still heavy. Place the machine onto the frame with the help of another person. Joshua is going to help me with this. As mentioned also in our main video of the studio frame, the machine is placed onto the frame after mounting the top and back rail. Just be careful, as the machine could fall from the frame until the idler rail is mounted. The handles come in this box, and the first thing we do is loosen the levers and pull out the left and right sides of the handles. This will give us access to the screws inside of the piece we're going to mount. Be careful, the handle sides are loose and behave like wild octopuses now. Now screw the handles on from underneath. There are two slotted nuts inside the groove towards the front of the sew head. Insert the cable. Push the handle sides inwards again. Holding the left and right handle in your preferred position, turn the locking ring only that much that the lever can be pushed down completely. Pushing the lever down should not be too hard. A tip I would like to give you is to fasten the handles only that much that you are still able to move them without having to open the levers each time. You can adjust also the angle of the handles to your liking. Your machine is now ready to quilt.
BERNINA, made to create.